Hello, in this final video on grammatical concepts, I'm going to talk about parsing trees. So we'll see what they are in a second. We need just a little bit of terminology to sort of summarize what we've talked about so far. So a string of symbols is just going to be some symbols in a row. So it might be P arrow Q is a string of symbols. That's a sentence in informal notation. Parenthesis P arrow Q parenthesis, that's a sentence in official notation. Arrow negation Z, that's gobbledygook. Negation Z arrow Q R parenthesis. Oh, I left out a parenthesis there, but yeah, that's also gobbledygook. Negation parenthesis P arrow Q parenthesis, that's another sentence in official notation. All of those are strings. So we can say a string of symbols might be one of three things. It might be a sentence in official notation, and when is it that? If and only if it's so according to those four rules. A string is blah, blah, blah. A sentence is in informal notation if and only if you could produce something, a sentence by, or a string is in informal notation, by building up a sentence according to official notation and then dropping the final external set of parentheses if that sentence had external parentheses. Or the string might just be what we call not well formed if it's anything else. So those are our three categories: official notation, informal notation, and not well formed. And those are the three. If we have some symbols in front of us, we can ask, is it in a sentence in informal notation? Is it a sentence in official notation? Is it a sentence in informal notation? Or is it just not well formed at all? And we saw examples of all of those. Now, when you build a tree, then it might, or a sentence, it might be either in something you end up with, official or informal. But when you build it, you start at the bottom, so you start with atomic letters, and you might put them together, say, into a conditional, and then you might take, say, another atomic sentence and put a negation on it, and then you can put them all together using the conditional rule again. So the things on the bottom, as it turns out, those are all atomic, so that's rule one. The PRQ, that's rule two, or excuse me, rule three applied to the atomic letters, and the P into negation P, that's rule two of our list of grammatical rules, and then we apply rule three again to build the top. And this is a tree, it's an upside down tree, but you know, it looks kind of like a tree. And it shows how the sentence, how the thing at the top was built up from its pieces, right? We took the P and the Q, put them together, took the P, put a negation on it, and then took those and stuck them together. So when we're building a sentence, we can, instead of saying writing all out, we can just draw it out in a tree where it all comes together at the top. An upside down tree, but that's fine. So this and the tree displays how the sentence was built, and the process could go on forever, right? We could say, oh, well, I'd like to put an R on the front of that and make a new conditional. So you could do that and just keep going and going and going and going. But once you're done, what we have, this thing is called a parsing tree, because when you look it down at it, it shows how the tree, how the sentence at the top is built up from its parts, or alternately, how it breaks down into its parts. You know, the thing at the top has two parts, the P or Q and the not P, and then the not P has one part, as far as sentences go, the P, and the P or Q has two sentences inside of it, the P and the Q. So the parsing tree shows how a sentence is built up or broken down into the sentences out of which it's made, where we are getting rid of the logical vocabulary and the parts are just the sentences. So when you're given a sentence, you can break it down, right? You break it down into the P or Q and the not P, and then you break the P or Q down into the P and the Q, and you break the not P down into the P, and you say, oh, now I see. I started with P arrow Q arrow not P with the parentheses, and now I've broken it down, and I see how it was built. So this is a parse. So you're going to have homework that does this, where you parse a sentence. And how do you do that? What we're doing when we're parsing it is we're building the parsing tree, and that means we're breaking a sentence into its parts. So at each step, you find the main connective, and you get rid of it, and you break the sentence into its immediate parts, which is what we did. And you just repeat that until you get down to sentence letters and all the branches of the tree, and then you're done. And that's it. That's all you need to do. And what that does is it produces the parsing tree of the sentence, which shows how it was originally built using the grammatical rules. So there's a parsing module in the program, and what's going to happen is you're going to be given a string, just some symbols in a row, and you have to figure out, is it a sentence in official notation, is it a sentence in informal notation, or is it a sentence in, is it not a sentence at all, is it not well-formed? And if it's a sentence in official or informal notation, then you will produce the parsing tree for it. Now, if it's not well-formed, like this, this looks like a sentence, A arrow Z with parentheses around it, but it's not, because A is not a it's not a sentence letter, right? Sentence letters are just P through Z. This is obviously not a sentence, okay? There's no tree to be constructed for either of these. Why? Well, because a tree shows how a sentence was built according to the rules, but those aren't sentences because they weren't built according to the rules, and so there's nothing to show about how they were built according to the rules, so it's not, there's no parsing tree at all. A not well-formed string is not built according to the rules, and so there's no parsing tree. So what you'll be doing in the parsing module, and there's a video with examples, but what you'll be doing is you'll be figuring out whether a sentence is in one of those three categories. Official, informal, not well-formed, and if it's official or not well-formed, then it has a parsing tree, and you will produce the parsing tree in the module. So that's, and you'll see that these homework problems are really, really easy, and so that's nice, easy way to get points. The point of it is to help you, just by practicing it, you'll learn to be able to just more easily recognize a sentence's grammatical structure, which will be helpful in the derivations and some other kinds of problems we'll be doing later on. So one more video on the parsing module, and then also a separate video showing how to deal with more tricky symbolization problems by using this idea of a main operator.